Good morning, everybody, and it's Christine here. And this morning, I want to share about the life of Freddie Mercury. Freddie Mercury is one of my favorite rock and roll singer. And Freddie Mercury was a British singer-songwriter, record producer, and lead vocalist of the rock band Queen. Regarded as one of the greatest singers in the history of rock music, he was known for his flamboyant stage persona and poor vocal range. He's born in September 5, 1946, in Stone Town, Tanzania, and died in November 24, 1991, in Kensington. His full name is Farouk Bulsara, and parents are Bonnie Bulsara and Jer Bulsara. He's got a whole bunch of albums. It's Mr. Bad Guy, A Night of the Opera, Innuendo, Barcelona, Queen It, News of the World, The Great Pretender, A Kind of Magic, Sheer Heart, and more and more. I'm going to show you a little bit of his video before we continue with his biography. Okay, let's stop there, guys. I know I love that music too, but let's continue on with the life of Freddie Mercury. So the life of Frederick Bozara began on the East African island of Zanzibar on September 5th, 1946. 25 years later, in London, under the name of Freddie Mercury, he was fronting the now legendary rock group named Queen. The son of Bommy and Jerry Bozara, Freddie spent the bulk of his childhood in India, where he attended St. Peter's boarding school. He began taking piano lessons at the age of 7. No one could foresee where a love of music would take him. Let's continue the song again, everybody. So, I love that music so much. So, the Bozara family moved to Middlesex in 1964, and from there, Freddie joined up with a blues called Wreckage while studying graphic design courses at Ealing College of Art. And while singing for Wreckage, a fellow student introduced Freddie to Roger Taylor and Brian May, founder members of a band called Smile. Smile metamorphosed into Queen when Freddie joined Roger and Brian as the lead vocalist. The final member of the band, which was to say together for the next 20 years, was bassist John Deacon, who joined the band on the 1st of March 1971. The rest is rock history. Emmy Records and Elektra Records signed the band, and in 1973, their debut album Queen was released and hailed as one of the most exciting developments ever in the rock music. Enjoy. Under pressure. So, the immortal operatically styled singed Bohemian Rhapsody was released in 1975 and proceeded to the top of the UK charts for 2 9 weeks, a song that was nearly never released due to its length and unusual style, but which Freddie insisted would be played, became the instantly recognizable hit. By this time, Freddie's unique talents were becoming clear, a voice with a remarkable range and a stage presence that gave Queen its colorful, unpredictable, flamboyant personality. I want to play a little bit of one of her of his favorite song here called I Want to Break Free, and it's live, and I want to share this to you, just a portion of it. So very soon, Queen's popularity extended beyond the shores of the UK as they charted and triumphed around Europe, Japan, and the USA, where in 1979, they topped the charts with Freddie's song, Crazy Little Thing of Love.
Sometimes I get to feeling I was back in the old days, long ago, when we were kids, when we were young. Things seemed so perfect, you know. The days were endless, we were crazy, we were young. The sun was always shining, we just lived for fun. Sometimes it seems like late. Those were the days.
So that's Freddie Mercury's last performance before he passed away. So that's just a little bit of view of the life of Freddie Mercury. And I hope you enjoy that. And if you want to watch more of their videos, you can actually search it on YouTube. So just want to ask you to subscribe. Just please subscribe and like on my channel. And we'll share more videos in the future. Thank you and have a nice day.